Hey guys, I'm Kidron Cannon from Cannon Wedding Photography, and I make all the wedding videos that you see on this channel. Today I'm going to be talking about the main tool that I love and use for filmmaking, and that is the Glidecam. So a few weeks ago we went on a West Coast road trip. It was me, Becca, who does all the photography at Cannon Wedding Photography, and a couple friends of ours who shoot with us all the time. On our trip, I brought my Glidecam and my camera and I did an awesome video, and I thought this would be a good opportunity to share a little bit about how I get the shots that I get both in wedding videos and on videos like our West Coast trip. So pretty much ever since I got into filmmaking, I've been using a Glidecam. As you'll see in all our wedding videos, or pretty much any video I do, there's lots of moving, smooth cinematic shots. I like for all of my shots pretty much to be just constantly moving because it gives it that more cinematic look. And with Glidecam, it's so easy. It's like second nature to get those shots. A Glidecam is a gimbal stabilizer, and it seems like everyone has a stabilizer these days in videos, and most of them are electronic stabilizers, like a Ronin or a Movi or something like that. People always ask me why I don't use an electronic stabilizer, but I prefer to use a mechanical stabilizer, a traditional kind of old school stabilizer. It doesn't have any motors, there's nothing electronic, no software. It's basically just some pieces of metal and it's balanced. So I'm gonna be talking about how I got a lot of shots on our trip and showing you guys some footage from the trip and also some behind the scenes of me filming with the Glidecam. So I've been filming on Glidecams for years and this is my second Devin Graham Signature Series Glidecam. I had another one for about 5 years, but I just destroyed it. I got it wet way too many times and in the salt water and just all kinds of stuff. And it's really tough, like you can put it through a lot, but I just had it way too long. So I asked Glidecam if they'd be willing to send me another one, and I told them I'd make some videos because I love their products and I don't mind talking about them anyway. They haven't paid me, they haven't told me what to say, but these are all just my opinions and I'm going to be talking about my new Glidecam. I made another video on how to set it up, what it comes with, how to balance it and get going, so make sure to check that video out too. There's a link down in the description. This video is going to be more about the ways to use it and more tips and tricks and examples. Now I can't really talk too much about a Glidecam without explaining why I don't use something that might seem easier to most people, which would be an electronic gimbal. Number one, personally, I just like the look that you get from a mechanical stabilizer. I think it looks more organic and less fake. It just looks more real. Now there's some really good electronic stabilizers out there too. A Glidecam does take more time and practice, but I think in the end, you get a much better product and a more clean product. And it's a lot more convenient to have a mechanical stabilizer, especially if you're gonna be traveling, hiking, going to extreme environments and stuff like that. Two, I really like Glidecams because you have 100% control. There's no guesswork in what it's going to do. And if you move too much this way, is the motor gonna like catch up or overcorrect or something? It's literally just you and your two hands and you are in 100% control of it. And I really like that. There's also no lag between when you make a movement and the gimbal responding to it because it's fully mechanical. With electronic stabilizers, you might want to make a movement or a turn and then it's half a second for the motor to kind of realize what you're doing and catch up. The motor's kind of guessing what you want it to do. With a mechanical stabilizer, there's none of that. There's no guesswork. It's 100% you and you're 100% in control of it. Another awesome thing is there are no batteries to power it. So if you're out in the woods or if you're just traveling, you don't have time to find a power outlet and your charger and charge your batteries, there's none of that. It's literally just metal, so there's nothing to charge, there's nothing to keep up with, there's no firmware updates and stuff. It's also a big benefit if you're gonna be outside, if it's gonna be raining or you'll be in a really humid or wet environment. Sometimes those motors on the electronic ones can gum up or get wet and things can get ruined. With a Glidecam, you shouldn't get it wet, but it's okay if it does get wet. Just take care of it and do your best, but you can put it through a lot, and I have.
And six.
And like I said, this thing is very tough. I mean, it's just a piece of metal. I'm always out like hiking and stuff, and it's nice because you can just throw it over your shoulder. If you don't need it for a second, you can lean it against the tree. You can literally just lay it on the ground. And when you're traveling, it's really nice because you don't have to have like a special carrying case and worry about it getting like out of whack. You literally just take your camera off and just throw the Glidecam in a bag, throw it in the bottom of a suitcase, wherever. It would take a lot to break it. And another fantastic thing, when you're out in the field, if you're shooting a wedding, if you're hiking or whatever, and you don't want to be holding it or wearing your arms out, you can just throw it over your shoulder, lean it right there. I'm not hardly using any energy. I can lean it right here on my belt. if I just want to rest for a minute, or I can leave it on the ground. I don't have to have some type of stand with me that you have to have with a lot of electronic stabilizers. Just to put it down, you have to have someone else to carry a stand so that you can set it down. Glidecam, there's none of that. You just lay it on the ground or lean it against the wall. One other thing that's extremely beneficial, and it's hard to really understand unless you're in the moment and you do it, but it's a lot quicker to set up and to be rolling on a Glidecam than it is electronic stabilizer, because if I'm walking around just holding it or something, I see a shot, it's that fast to be ready to film it. Versus with an electronic stabilizer, I have to get it out, turn it on, set it up, wait for it to boot up, wait for it to be ready, make sure there's no issues with it. With a Glidecam, you pick it up and you're ready to go. And there were lots of times on our trip and other times filming when I see something's about to happen and you only have a second to react and get ready and be in filming position. With Glidecam, it's just that fast. Another great thing about Glidecam, even if you haven't had tons of practice and if you don't want to get all the gliding shots, it can be a great way to get sort of a handheld looking shot, but it's going to be more stable than just holding the camera in your hands because you have all this weight and it keeps it a little bit more stable than just hand holding it, even if you're just holding the pole and you're not using it correctly. So one thing that electronic and mechanical stabilizers both allow you to do is get smoother shots on pretty much any terrain. If you're walking across like rocky surfaces, if you're hiking up a trail, if you're running down a path, like anywhere you go, you can take it. And I just love having that freedom to be able to toss it over my shoulder, hand it off to someone, hike up a trail. I can stand on the edge of a cliff and just film in crazy situations, and I know it's gonna work. The only time I can even think of where you might need an electronic stabilizer and a Glidecam wouldn't work is if you only have one hand, if you're filming like out the side of a car or something and you've only got one hand to stick out there. An electronic stabilizer might be better for that, but 99% of the time, the Glidecam is going to get the job done and it's going to be more convenient and just easier. But with all that said, it does take some dedication, it does take some time and effort into using it and learning how to use it and getting good at it. So as someone who's been using Glidecam for years, here are some of my like top tips and tricks for filming on Glidecam. First, you want to be gentle. And what I mean by that is your hand that's holding it, you want to have it firm, but on your other hand, the one that's just kind of helping guide it and keep it smooth, use your secondary hand just to kind of tap it in place, keep it from getting out of whack, and as you move, just kind of help keep it balanced. You also want to be gentle and smooth when you're walking and moving. Whenever you see me moving around filming on Glidecam, I'm always kind of rolling my feet from the heel of my foot to the ball. And it looks kind of goofy as I'm filming, but it helps you get better footage. I also like to crouch, keep my knees bent as I'm moving, and that helps keep smoother footage as well. Another type of shot that I like to get with Glidecam is what I call glider. So you've heard of a slider, when you mount the camera on a slider and you get moving shots that are very smooth. Well, you can get a lot the same with the Glidecam, but without having all the setup. And all you do is you squat down and kind of glide from side to side. And it can look a lot like slider footage, but there's nothing to set up, and you can get it just like that. Another great thing about Glidecam, and especially the Devin Graham Signature Series Glidecam, is the ability to flip it upside down and get really awesome low mode shots. It's different on the Devin Graham Signature than it has been from past Glidecams like the HD 4000 or 2000, because the center pole, the handle can be moved from the top to the bottom, and when you do that, it shifts the weight and flips the camera, but keeps it balanced. And doing this is super easy. You literally just set it down, twist these knobs below the handle, slide them down, lock them back into place, grab the handle, flip it over, and now the camera will automatically flip upside down and be balanced just like it was right side up, but now you're getting awesome low mode shots, and it happens in literally just a couple seconds. I do this sometimes while I'm moving, while I'm walking. I just see a shot, I flip it upside down, I get the shot, and it's smooth. And I love this because it enables you to get a lower perspective than you'd be able to get otherwise, and it's really fast. When you're done, you just flip it right back up, twist again, bring the handle back up to where you started, and lock it back into place, and you're ready to go again. If you're filming something for a long time and it's like a really long shot, your arms are getting tired, you can easily just kind of tuck it right here on your belt, rest it on your belt or on your hip, something like that, and you can still get really smooth footage. It's gonna definitely be smoother than handheld. Another type of shot that I like to get on Glidecam is one kind of looking over an edge or looking down from that perspective, and it's very easy. As you're moving, you just tilt, lean out over your subject, and I love shots like that because it's a different perspective than you'd be able to get with the naked eye, leaning out over a ledge, and it's also really easy to get. As you can see, the variety of types of shots you can get with Glidecam is pretty much endless. You can take it anywhere. You're not gonna break it. You can throw it over your shoulder. You don't have to worry about how you carry it or breaking it or knocking it against something. It's super tough. Everything I shot in this West Coast video that's moving, besides the drone shots, were all shot on Glidecam. I don't think there was ever a situation where I wanted to get a shot that I couldn't because of the Glidecam. It enabled me to get everything that I needed to. So even now in 2019, when there's like 1,000 different types of electronic gimbals out there, I still like the mechanical ones best because I like the look, I like the feel, I like the reliability of it, and I like being able to take it anywhere without worrying about it getting damaged or broken or something failing. And even when it comes to mechanical stabilizers, I've tried quite a few different ones, and I've honestly, 100% honestly, never found the same quality in any other brand other than Glidecam. But I've used probably 4 or 5 different brands of the mechanical gimbals, and the only one I've ever used that I was actually willing to use like on a daily basis and use in my workflow and professionally is Glidecam, because I honestly think that they're just the best. You might pay a little more than you would for like a cheap gimbal, but in the end, you're going to get a much higher quality product and it's going to work for you. You're gonna be able to rely on it. And the people at Glidecam are awesome. Like if you ever have an issue, you can just email them. They'll always respond and help you out. You don't have anything to worry about. They're in the US, there's not a language barrier. They're super helpful. For my money, I'm always going to pick Glidecam. I just think they're the best. All right, that's all I've got for today. I hope you learned something from this. I hope I didn't ramble on too much, but maybe you took a few tips away. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them below. Also follow us on Instagram at Canon Wedding Photography. I also have a YouTube and Instagram myself, Kid Canon TV, everywhere. Feel free to message me. I'm happy to answer any questions that you might have about anything I film with, especially Glidecam. Don't forget to subscribe. Click the notification icon to be notified when we put out a new video. Thank you so much for watching. Peace.